This video will present the new features for permissions in document management. We will start by looking at the role menu, since the roles are the key to defining permissions. In parameters menu, general, and department and role management. By selecting the role under the permission tab, you will be able to find the permissions for document management. These permissions are similar to our last version, except that the assigned reading column has been moved. The permissions tab therefore allows you to assign permissions to modify or view documents via folders and subfolders for a group of users. In this shot, we see the mirror images of these definitions in the other definition screens. In a folder, you can assign, modify, and view permissions to various departments and roles. And in the user definition screen, you can assign, modify, and view permissions to folders for a user. The definitions are the same for all three screen views. If you have the right to modify, you automatically have the right to view, but no longer automatically have readings assigned to you. A user with modify permissions on a document will no longer automatically receive all reading requests, unless defined as such. We completely overhauled how users receive reading requests. The most important philosophy change is that the role is now pivotal to reading requests. The reading assignment column was moved to a new tab called Readings. You can assign readings, but only to folders for which the role has view permissions. For each role, you will have two buttons to choose from. The first one, Reading Assignation, will allow you to identify all documents that members of this role must read. This view will list all documents the members of the role must presently read. You can also use the back button to assign new readings by using the green plus assign button. In this screen, you can choose other documents. For any given role, you can define any additional documents that all members of this role will have to read. The documents are displayed using the familiar folder and subfolder tree configuration. You can select all documents in a folder by selecting the Yes option, and you can do the same thing for subfolders. You can also select only certain documents per folder or subfolder. What is important to remember is that if you select Yes for all documents in a folder, it will affect any future documents being added to this folder. We will review this in a few minutes. When we save the modifications made to this screen, all reading requests and assignments will be sent out to the users. So make sure that this is what you want before hitting the Save button. We recommend you save the modifications on this screen before moving on. This sums up the changes we made to the role, which is now, as we said previously, key to defining permissions. The role reading request definition will also be mirrored in the user profile under the permission tabs in document management. You will be able to see the readings inherited by the role and assign new permissions to modify or view for this user. You can see which documents the user is required to read with the button on the top left of this box. This is the same as under the role, where you can see the list of documents that the user must read. Again, you can see this displayed in a folder and subfolder tree configuration. In this case, my user Tech2, which is a member of the previous role we discussed, which had to read the documents that were in folder A. We can see that these documents are in this list. This allows our view to be dynamic. Even though we can see which readings a user must do in his or her profile, one cannot assign a reading to a user directly from his or her profile. If we compare screens, earlier we were looking at role 4, and we could see that each member of this role had to read the document Politic 1, which is part of folder A. and that one of the members of this role was Tech 2. We see here that this user also is required to read the document Politic 1. Both screens are dynamic and reflect changes that we made. We will now be looking at the folder view or screen under Parameters, Document Management, Folders. We can see that this view is also linked to the readings that are assigned. This association is really for default values. We can find once again the permissions to modify and view, but this time, for assigned readings, we will find a new field. This field is available at the folder and subfolder level. This will allow us to assign readings by default for all documents that are found in this folder or subfolder. By default means that it will apply to the first version of the document only. If I add a document in folder A, automatically this will assign readings to both these roles. Since these are default roles, we will be able to modify them. This is a starting point to help users that are creating new documents. We can modify this default reading assignments in the folder by selecting roles and departments in the drop-down menu. This will assign readings to the entire folder and subfolder, which simplifies our work. It is important to know that if you had selected Yes in the role screen, this will add the role as a default in the drop-down menu. Let's now look on how all this works together when we look at the document itself. Let's create a new document. The first thing to understand is the importance of the folder you choose. If I choose to place this document in folder A, it will impact the other drop-down menus and tabs in this document edit screen. For example, it will affect the permissions tab, so once I select the folder, it will show me all the roles and departments that can modify or view this document, as well as specific users, as requests can be given manually to specific users. If we look at the readings tab, we can see there is an assigned reading that is set by default, which means that by associating the document to folder A, all assigned readings by default for that folder will apply to this document. Again, since this is a default setting, we can modify it. But if we do, we can only select roles that have view permissions for the documents in this folder. So if a role does not have the permission to view this folder, they will be grayed out, which means they won't have the settings by default. But we can add them manually. We can make this change before publishing the document, as I just did, by using the drop-down menu, and I can add other roles that are not set by default, but that I can add as exceptions. Once this is done, I can save and publish the document, and I will still have the option to modify it. So we save, publish, and once published, we can go back to the Readings tab, and it is possible to change the reading assignments. Of course, at this point, the document is active and available, so anything that is not yet read will be archived and will be included in reports, but we can manage reading assignments at any time without the need to create a new version or change folders. The option to manually assign reading requests is still available, but it has been improved as it is now possible to send reading requests to any user who have view permissions on a document, but who is not part of a role that was automatically designed to receive reading requests. Basically, we can send a reading request to any user as long as this user can see the document in his search. The manual reading feature provides you with great flexibility. It is dynamic and only available once the document is published. We can also move a document from one folder to another at any time. If I move my document from folder A to folder B, a message will show stating that the readings will not be modified. So if I look at the reading tab, the folder change did not affect my reading assignments. But I could do so if I wanted to after saving the changes from folder A to folder B. Once again, the changes are dynamic, so as soon as we save, we will see the impact. Default reading assignations determined by the folder in which a document is found will only affect version 1. If we have a document in version 1 that is in folder A, as shown in the lower right frame, automatically there will be readings assigned by the default for the two roles that are defined. If I change the folder for this document that is in version 1 and that is not published, I will not get a message and automatically the assigned readings by default role selection will change. This is a feature that is specific for version 1 documents only. If we create a new version, the reading assignments will automatically follow the settings for the previous version. Version 2 would automatically show under the Readings tab the same assigned readings as we had previously selected. This is also true if we renew with minor modifications or without modifications. What you need to remember if you look at version 1 and version 2, which is not yet published, is that there is a difference in the assigned readings because in this case, the version 1 we changed the document from folder A to B and also created a new version. By creating the new version, the roles that did not have the permissions to view the documents disappeared. This is why in version 1, there are 3 roles that could read the documents, while in version 2, there is only 1 role left. This shows a bit of the relationship or link between permissions to view and assigned readings. Of course, we can also change the assigned readings for version 2 and add any roles that can see the documents for the new folder. Please do not hesitate to contact us should you have any questions about these new features.